Hi, from an almost empty office building. Back in March, in response to the coronavirus pandemic, ING decided to split its operations globally to protect our colleagues and ensure that we could keep supporting our customers with a full range of services. Our digital focus and the technology foundation that we have laid in recent years has allowed us to respond rapidly. Around 80% of all ING staff worldwide is now working from home, with some of our branches remaining open for customers who need support that can't be provided remotely. Of course, in times of crisis, it's not enough to only provide the usual support. This pandemic has hit our customers hard, and we are doing our part to help them through this difficult time. Banks play an important role in society, and we need to live up to it now more than ever. And as these are unprecedented times, rather than to focus on ING's results and commercial successes, I'd like to share with you a couple of examples of how we're providing extra help to customers and communities. For struggling business and retail customers, we're offering financial flexibility with deferrals of loan and mortgage repayments. And we've ramped up efforts to help people switch to safer online banking and contactless payments. Local ING businesses are making donations of funds, equipment and expertise to support healthcare and social services in the communities where we operate. And globally, we've partnered with UNICEF to raise funds for health, education and social services for children and their caregivers in the developing world. Our first quarter results show that ING's business is also feeling the impact of the coronavirus. While we saw customer growth and further income diversification, we also needed to set aside significantly higher amounts for possible future loan losses, accounting for the expected effects of the pandemic on the economy. Please check ING.com for more on how we're helping customers and communities deal with the impact of the coronavirus pandemic and for all the information about ING's results. I usually end by saying, see you next time. But this is my last quarterly results video as ING's CEO. I'd like to say thank you and goodbye. It's been a true honor to lead this company, to restructure it from a bank insurance company into a bank and transform the bank into a dynamic digital player with a true customer-led focus. And therefore, to all of the customers, everybody involved with ING, and certainly all my colleagues, thank you for your support.